So I've been asked a few times how I set up the performance surface in Loopy Pro in my other video. So I thought I'd make a quick video to show you how I did it. Here's the mixer view in Loopy Pro. You'll see there's three instances of Atom 2, and then some synths, Koala, and Italizer by Kaya Russ. Dubstation as a send. There's Italizer. Atom 2 is the first instance, triggering the drums. Second instance triggers the bass. The third instance triggers the kind of trumpet sound from BS-16. And then Koala's got some reggae dub lyrical samples in there. So to trigger the drums, I've got this button widget here on the left. So if I add a toggle action, send MIDI message to the appropriate Atom 2 instance, then I'm going to send it a note, leave everything else that it is. That means it sends C4, which is a nice easy note to remember. Then in Atom itself, hold down the launch button and you get these options. To get this set up, just choose the launchpad style and then switch it to stop at note off. Make sure the launch note is set to C4 and you're good to go. As you can see, press the button and it launches the clip. Press the button again, unlaunches it, press it again, launches it, etc. Then this theory is used on the other Atom 2 instances as well. So the bass here, you can see I've set it up in exactly the same way. It's launchpad style, stop a note off, make sure the launch note's C4. Oh, and make sure you turn off through all input, otherwise you get a weird drone note coming through from the button widget. So the yellow button widget is set up in exactly the same way. Toggle action, send a MIDI message, and then target that to the appropriate Atom 2 instance. Send it the default note, C4. That toggles it on and off. As you can see, you can toggle it on and off whenever you want. It quantizes the launch because I've got it set to launch on beat 4, I think. So it's always in time with everything else. Then the same for the trumpet. I've got that linked to this little orange button here. Exactly the same toggle action, just pointed at the other Atom 2 instance. Oh, for these crazy dub siren sounds. I've used Itilizer. You'll see I've got an XY grid widget and this dial widget here. This dial is actually doing a few different things all at the same time. If you hit MIDI map in Itilizer, I've set the feedback just now to see how that turns the feedback knob in the bottom right. You'll see in a second how I'm doing that. So the XY pad is sending CC10 on the X axis change, Y axis change, CC11 and CC14. So I've mapped, as you can see, MIDI map those CCs to different things. So the X axis changes the oscillation frequency, and then the LFO and the filter cutoff are on the Y axis. So if you move it all together, you get this kind of effect. And then by messing with the feedback knob as well, you can get, well, pretty much everything I want out of a dub siren. The button in the top right, the red one, just sends a single note to the dub siren sometimes. It doesn't activate until you do that. So the dial on the right-hand side there, that's actually also affecting the send from Koala and BS16. As you can see, if I set it to halfway, the sends are set to halfway. That send is to Dubstation, so it's the amount of tape echo that's happening on those channels. These buttons are just sending, literally just sending notes to Koala, these three yellow buttons. So they just trigger samples, really simple. Effectively just one shot. And as you can hear, the echo is affected by turning the knob. Also the trumpet sound from BS16, that also goes through the same Dubstation send, so it's all controllable by that one widget. You could of course set up multiple widgets for all of it, but it's quite fun having it all in nice one setup on an iPhone. And that's it. You should be able to do all of this. If you've got any questions, just put them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer.